Don Teague and Raf Raf Barak. 10 years ago, their lives were as different as could be. Don was a respected journalist with a family and the American dream. Raf Raf Barak was a young Muslim woman living in Baghdad, struggling to find herself in a war-torn existence. Then it happened, September 11th, 2001.
When September 11th happened, I had an overwhelming feeling that my life was going to change. It was shortly after that that I ended up being hired by NBC News, and I was going to find myself in a war.
I grew up in Baghdad in a family of 10 kids. I was 10 years old when the Gulf War started, and I would sit home and watch the war right outside my door, and it's bombing, you know, kind of, to us it was colors in the sky and loud noises, and we would ask my parents about it, and they would say, oh, it's just, you know, bad people. We later knew that the people who were attacking us are Americans, so we grew up with the idea that America is so bad.
Raf Raf's government sent her to major in English. Despite her fear of Americans, Raf Raf became a translator for NBC in 2003.
It was kind of a struggle to just stay focused. Well, this is a job, I need to make the money, and I need to be careful until I know who these people are. People didn't see me as someone that is helping the country.
Don Teague was on assignment in Baghdad when he struck up an unlikely friendship with his translator, Raf Raf. The two were on assignment together at a local school when insurgents attacked.
It's supposed to be a happy story. And talking to the kids, talking to everybody, they said, oh, we have one more interview. We went, we stood there, we're trying to do the interview when the bomb went off. And when it went off, I could not think of a thing at that time. I just froze in my place. The first thing I heard after that was Don's voice. He was saying, Raf Raf, it's a bomb, come inside, come inside. So we ran to the car and everyone got their body vests. And Don at the time put his body vest on and looked at me and said, where's yours?
Raf Raf didn't have her body armor that day.
He took his and put it on me and said, here, take mine.
I just was aware of the fact that I was alive, and I was so happy that I was alive and I was going to get to go home to my wife and kids. And Raf Raf was there next to me, and she was home. This was as good as it was going to get for her.
So then all these ideas started like hitting me in the head, like, what if these kids are hurt? What if, you know, one of them got killed in this bomb? Why would my own people kill my own people for such a reason? Why would a foreigner that I don't even know, that I just met a few weeks ago, gives me his vest? It was a wake-up call to me that maybe everything that I know about everything in my life is wrong. And maybe I need to rethink every single step of my life.
All of the crew members managed to escape unharmed that day.
There was a reason that this woman had been put in my life, and she was going to die if I didn't do something.
Don and his wife Kiki, with the help of other NBC correspondents, fought to bring Raf Raf to the United States for asylum.
It took 7 months of really beating our heads against the wall. Yeah, it was impossible.
But during those 7 months, despite the odds, Don and Kiki prayed and held tight to their faith. And Raf Raf finally made it safely to the United States.
But it wasn't until I saw her sitting in my living room the day she got here. She still had her scarf on. She had her long clothes on. And it just hit me like a ton of bricks. I'm like, oh my gosh, she's left everything. I could see how much God loved her. Not because of who she was going to be or what she was going to do, but just because of who she was. He just loved her.
I was looking at the way they treated me. I mean, they opened more than just their house to me. They opened their hearts. And I had a talk with Kiki. I said, why are you helping me? And she said, God told me to. And I did not understand because I don't know that God. And at the time, all I have in mind is the God that I had grew up with. And yeah, I didn't have that much of a strong relationship with him. And then I started questioning other things, like, why was I saved? Why was I that lucky? I was in a bombing. I was in a shooting. I was in a kidnapping attempt. I was in so many different things. but I stayed safe. Okay, wait a second. That's the God that she's talking about. That's the God that has saved me. That's the God that had been with me along the way.
Finally, after 4 years in the United States, a dream helped Rafraf make a decision.
I was dying in the dream, and I was running away from my house, which had the word sin on it.
In the dream, Rafraf found herself on the edge of a mountain with no way to cross to the other side.
There's this lady that tells me that I'm gonna die any minute, and she needs to tell me the words. She needs to teach me words to cross the bridge to God. But I couldn't even understand the words, and I'm like, teach me quick, and then I died. And I woke up, and I was really scared. And I went and grabbed my computer, and it came out with this site that said, imagine yourself on the edge of a mountain. You must be with me in the dream. And it goes to explain that this is where you are in life, and you're with your sins on one side of that mountain, on that edge. And the only way to cross that gap between you and the other edge of the mountain to God is by accepting Christ.
1 week later, Rafraf asked Kiki to help her pray. Kiki led her through a prayer to receive Christ.
It's a relationship. It feels, you know, whenever I need him, I could talk to him. It's a love relationship, you know, respect and friendship, not fear. I'm not scared of God, you know, I love him.
Today, Rafraf is attending university and is touring the country with Don to share her story. The two have collaborated on a book called Saved by Her Enemy.
I think that if you look at the story of Rafraf and see how he moved in her life over a series of years and so many things that there was no other way to explain that ultimately led her to him, I think that becomes the message of the book.
I just hope that people would, you know, realize that there's more to God and there's more to people. And when God is working in people's lives, it's all different. Because God is working everybody's life in a different way. Whether it's little or much, He is there and He's doing His work.